All right. Take three.
Take three.
For Disaster Saturday.
Disaster Saturday. And we won't even tell you why.
No, it'll... because it's November.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. See how quickly she converted to the dark side on that one? Oh, real fast. Real fast. What did you think about Pink Print? I played earlier for you.
Which one's that?
Oh, God. Oh, my God. Disaster Saturday. Nicki Minaj, Pink Print, the album.
Oh, that's the album.
Yes. Oh, I'm sorry. I never told you that.
No.
Okay. Disaster.
Yeah, Disaster.
It's November.
I really liked it. I only knew the stereotypical stuff about Nicki Minaj, the stuff that you hear from the headlines.
What? Yeah, which is what? What is that? When you think of Nicki Minaj, what do you think of?
Oh, but then I'll sound really mean.
Well, but here's the thing, though, is, and this is something I shared during the reaction, and I think it's important for you, because... I think it's hard for fans of an artist, whoever it is, to understand that other people don't know them the way they know them. Whoever the artist is, whether it's Nicki Minaj, Drake, Kanye, whoever, right? Mm-hmm. The big fans know a lot about the artist, while everyone else just hears what you hear.
Because I didn't care enough to actually look into it to see if anything was true or whatever.
Right. But I mean, why would you? We don't look into anybody that you don't, we just don't do
no,
that.
No, I don't really look up people.
The average person is going to take the time and to find out, is this actually true? Is this an adequate representation of this person, what
right.
I'm hearing?
I'm not going to put that
nobody's
going to
do that.
After it.
So,
and that, I don't usually care.
All that said, what was your just thought of Nicki Minaj prior to hearing the album today?
Meh.
But, like, what does that mean? Give...
It was just trivial.
You don't want to be, like, mean right now. Huh?
No, I don't want to be mean.
I said trivial.
I
said during the reaction, when I thought of Nicki Minaj, I just thought of a girl shaking her ass and singing songs about sex.
Yeah, just surface and, like, something that you would buy at Claire's, just cheap.
What the hell is Claire's?
It's a hair accessories and earrings place.
Hair accessories, huh?
Beard accessories.
I guess that's hair. Okay. All right.
They don't have beard accessories, but so, we can make it happen.
So then when you heard, well, I mean, you even said like track one or track two, you're like, wow, this is pretty tough stuff.
Yeah. And then towards the end, the one with the grand piano. The grand piano. I really like that one a lot.
It's a hell of a song, man.
She has an amazing voice.
Yeah. She's singing.
Yeah.
In that one.
She can really sing.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it.
Yeah, I did too. No, yeah. I think Pink Print's great. I guess there's another one. It's called Pink Friday. It was her debut, and she's doing a lot more rapping on that one. I did this one. It went back and forth. Anyway, people have already heard this. So I don't want to rehash it, but it's just interesting how through no effort of our own, right, you can have this opinion about a person, whoever it is, because of the shit that you hear from media, from social media, just wherever it comes from and however it sticks to the brain. Mm-hmm. And that stuff really kind of terrifies me, honestly, because think about that across everything, across politics, across social ideas, across everything. All these ideas that we have about things that we don't research on our own,
right.
Explore further.
But as long as you take those ideas what the saying is, with a grain of salt, and you don't act on them actually legitimately talk about someone unless you really know about them.
Inaction is also an action. And so if there's certain things like, you know, maybe we would be more supportive towards certain ideas or movements or culture shifts or whatever if we actually knew about them rather than what's portrayed.
Well,
you know,
if we stick with the whole Nicki Minaj thing, because that's where we're going, I had no interest in listening to her before because hip hop and everything is new. And so
that's true, too. Sure, sure.
I don't really care either way.
For me, it was more of an image. Like, I had an image of Nicki Minaj.
You care a lot more than I do.
Well, no, it was just anytime, and I think it's kind of like an amalgamation of headlines and photos I've seen with headlines and this. You know?
I haven't even seen photos.
And so if there's just that and that never paired to something like Grand Piano, ever, you know?
This is so not on my radar at all that...
All right, well, let's watch the video. She knows the song. She knows the sample. We did a reaction to Baby Got Back, the video, and that was fun.
That was fun.
I liked, I remember the part where we were, I think it was the beginning, where it's the two girls like, oh my God, look at her butt. It's so big. And we were both like, it's not even a big butt. Like, what's going on? It's not even big. So let's kick us off here. That was, that, are we actually recording? Yes, okay. That would be funny. Do the whole thing without recording. It's Disaster Saturday, so. Yeah. All right, here we go. What's funny is I said all that about Nicki Minaj, and now we're going to watch a video about her doing God knows what.
I mean, the headlines have to start from somewhere. My anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun. Boy, Toy named Troy. I have a question.
Yeah.
Can you do that with your butt?
Do what? Oh, make it clap?
The
little...
Floofy, floof.
I tried yesterday.
You did?
I tried. When nobody else was here, I went to go take a shower when the video was running. I, like, tried to make my butt clap. It didn't go that well. My belly was jingling more than my butt was. The money, he was getting some coins. Was the shootout with the Lord? What do you think of those shoes?
Now that's real, real, real. Gun my ankles would be gone. Who wanna go first? I had them pushing daffodils. I'm high as hell, I only took a half a pill. I'm on some dumb shoes. By the way, what he say? He can tell I ain't missing no meals. Come through and fuck him in my automobile. Let him eat it with his grills. He keep telling me to chill. He keep telling me it's real that he love my sex appeal. He said he don't like I'm bony. He wants something he can grab. So I pull up in a jag and I hit him with a jab like dun 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 dun.
I don't know why this is so much easier for me than it would have been a couple months ago. Because I feel like even a couple months ago, I wouldn't have gotten into it. I honestly think doing Thriller last week really, like, cracked a barrier for me.
Really?
What? With just pop. And more so, I don't know if you heard me when I was doing the additional thoughts for Thriller, talking about how I was listening to all that dark shit for October. Mm-hmm. Dark shit, dark shit, dark shit. And I was like, God, I need a break. I need to... And so that's why I decided to do Thriller instead of the other Clipping album. And in doing that, it was nice to catch my breath. But then also, I was like, this is just fun.
Yeah, and that's how this one is.
It's fun.
It's just fun.
And like, I've always been... I don't know if I've just been too fucking pretentious or too like diving into songs in terms of lyrics and themes, and like I really enjoy that, but if I wonder if I got so deep I couldn't just do something that was fun.
I do feel like we should be watching this with soon to be bride, like tiaras on. And
it's so... Normally, I'd feel like these kind of videos would make me feel uncomfortable almost, because I felt like, oh, this just isn't my thing. Mm-hmm. And it was never my thing because I don't even know. But now I'm just like, no, this is just fun. And that's it. That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's weird because it's that simple, yet I made it that fucking complicated. I couldn't just come around to it. Yeah, I'm growing up. I'm growing up a little bit. I even got the little gray hairs in the side of my beard to prove it. And when we done, I make them buy me Bombay. I'm on some dumb shit. By the way, what he say? He can tell I'm missing no meals. Come through and fuck him in my... I love that line.
Did she say he can tell I'm missing no meals?
Yes, I love that line.
That's fabulous. Oh my goodness. It's real, he keep telling me to chill. He keep telling me it's real that he love my sex appeal. He said he don't like I'm bony. He wants something he can grab. So I pull up in the Jag, made weather with the jab. Like dun 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 dun.
I like that too. The dun 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 dun. My anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun. Oh my gosh. Look at her butt. Oh my gosh. Look at her butt. Oh my gosh. Look at her butt. Look at her butt.
Look at her butt.
I looked at her butt. Yeah.
I understand the banana.
Yeah. What about anaconda?
The pineapple is for hospitality.
Okay. I didn't know that.
Yeah, that's okay. Why in South Carolina they have the pineapple fountains and stuff.
Oh,
it's for hospitality.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't understand the apple and the lemon.
I don't either. I don't know. I would just be...
I mean,
guessing.
I would understand more of like a melon or a peach.
Mm-hmm. Big old peach. Maybe they just don't make peaches that big. So you got to get a lemon.
Lemon's not the right size.
No.
Or shape. And
right.
The app, I don't know.
She's going to bite her. Oh my God.
It's just a little nibble.
Just
it's
a nibble?
She doesn't have fangs. There's nobody's going to change into a werewolf or anything.
My anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun. My anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun.
Look at her butt. Yeah, he loved his fat ass. Oh, that's great. What's he gonna do? I didn't know he was gonna be in the video. Yeah. This one is for my bitches with a fat ass in the fucking club. I like the end. With my fat ass, big bitches in the club. Fuck the skinny bitches. Fuck the skinny bitches in the club. I wanna see all the big fat ass bitches in the motherfucking club. Fuck you if you skinny bitches. What? I like when she does. Yeah. She does it a couple times throughout the album. The little rolling R. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. I'm surprised he doesn't slap it. She probably would slap him back.
He did a little bit once.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
All right. Well, there we go. What'd you think?
That was funny.
Yeah, it was. I was kind of... I didn't know what to expect. I was expecting... I don't know. I don't know.
She made a mess of the whipped cream.
What a mess. And then she cut that banana in half.
I really like the look on her face when she tossed the banana. I didn't know if she was going to stuff the whole thing in her mouth or what she was going to do. That's what I was expecting. So the look on her face when she just, that was awesome.
You think she was disappointed because it was so small, the banana? Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Or maybe she just doesn't like them.
Why would she? Bananas suck.
So I've been told.
Yeah, we haven't had any bananas in the house lately.
They haven't been put on the grocery
list.
That's true. No, we did have one.
Oh, it was awful.
Yeah.
So for those of you who are unaware about the banana thing, we did a fruit tier list, and in that, she learned, after almost 20 years mm-hmm. of marriage, actually, I think it was 20, after 20, mm-hmm. that I don't like bananas, and she thought I liked bananas.
That's because you ask for them.
Yeah, but doesn't mean I like them. So her poor little world came crumbling down because she loves to care for me and give me the things that I like, which is very nice. And then she found out it was all a lie. That I don't like bananas. I only eat them for potassiums. Anyway, got into the conversation about how, you know, there's all these different varieties of banana. And when you go to the damn grocery store, it's usually the same kind. And so you tried. What was the one you bought?
It was a red one.
Yeah. Is that the official type of banana? Red yeah. one?
It was a red banana.
And it was not ripe. Even though the outside was dark, dark, dark.
It was like maroon.
And so it looked rotten on the outside, but it was still not ripe on the inside.
Yeah, it was almost like a plantain.
And it tasted worse than a banana.
Yeah. It was very starchy. It was like a plantain.
It was overly ripe on the outside and underripe on the inside and tasted worse than a banana.
I don't think it was ripe.
I don't think so. It was underripe. But what's the word for that? Non-ripe? Upside down ripe?
Wrong.
Backwards ripe?
Not good.
Okay.
Anyways, did you want to talk any more about the actual video that we just saw?
No. You know, it is funny, though, because I talked about how, you know, she's so much more than just the girl shaking her ass, and the whole video is her shaking her ass, and a bunch of other girls shaking her ass.
Yeah, but, I mean, she's doing that not to impress the guys. She's doing it to tease them.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
And she's doing it because she can.
Something I do find interesting is how I don't really know the people that don't like Nicki Minaj. I don't really know why. I've seen comments, people talking about how, you know, they're uncomfortable with how, you know, aggressive she is sexually and all this other stuff. And that makes some of the guys feel uncomfortable, which is very strange to me, given some of the lyrics I've heard. Throughout album after album after album, they want these girls that do all this crazy, nasty shit.
Maybe they don't. Well, and you also have to ask, are the same guys, because this is from the internet, right? So,
I'm just thinking about the album lyrics.
Okay, so the same guys saying they want this aggressiveness in females, are those also the same ones who are saying, oh,
I wonder if it's the aggressiveness. It's not so much they want someone who's aggressive, but they want someone who will just let them do anything they want to them. And here's a girl that is not that way. Instead, I'm going to do what I want to do, not you going to do what you want to do. Maybe that's what the problem is. I don't know. It's very strange to me, though.
Very strange. It's probably not the same people saying that.
Well, I'm going to live in my own little pretend world, so I'm right.
Yeah. That's what he does.
Yeah, it's fun. It's fun.
It's okay.
Until the stream lag catches up and then I'm wrong again.
Right. Yeah.
All right. That was good, huh?
That was good. That was fun.
It was fun.
I like that one.
Yeah. Yeah.
She's funny. She is entertaining and funny.
I like her. Are you going to turn into a Barb?
What's a Barb?
A Barb is a Nicki Minaj fan. Why a Barb? I think she's got like a Barbie theme. Actually, yeah, right there on the necklace, Barbie.
Oh.
And so the fans are Barbs. She's a Barbie and the fans are Barbs.
Well, I've heard one album.
Yeah. Yeah. We'll do Pink Friday at some point too.
So maybe, yeah.
Yeah.
Pink Friday?
That's her debut album.
Oh, okay. I thought that was like a holiday.
It comes right before Disaster Saturday.
That makes sense. I could definitely see Pink Friday coming before Disaster Saturday.
Or leading into Disaster Saturday. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure. All right, let's shut it down.
Okay.
All right. See you guys.